not what I wanted. Okay, double mute. That should all work out better. Alrighty, here we go. Surprise party of orcs, that's good. That's one encounter. That's kind of a big party of orcs. Mage doesn't have any spells yet. Not that big party of orcs. spells. Oh, wrong person worded that. No, he didn't. Bash down all the doors. Hardly need this, but I'm gonna be able to rest anyway, so. Sleep turns battles into easy mode. Jake, that leather armor is magic, that might be valuable money. One person said, okay, Cavs, Cure Memories, Blue, and Blue, Memorize. One encounter, where encounter, the other two were set. Surprised by orcs. Luckily, one of the best things about this position is that it keeps my mage from being targeted at all, so I can cast sleep spells if I can. Unfortunately, since they went first, they all ran around, so I only get four of them, but not bad. Again, lots of orcs. Not ideal. And I took damage. Oh, only gonna get three this time. I shouldn't even bother except I need to heal up anyway. Always best to be at full health when your hit points are so low. Every chance you get. Left, he surrenders. Excellent. Whoops. Uh-oh. That's four encounters. Accidentally hit the wrong button, smooth the wrong way. That is very unfortunate. You can rest freely without any chance of getting interrupted in set encounters that you clear on this map. Goblins have a reliable amount of bows and arrows, kobolds do not. Does 1 to 8, period, so if I'm down 6, I have only a 37.5% chance of, oh, there we go, goblins. Excellent. Only getting 5 there, but preventing those ones from running around. Ouch. This is low-level D&D, especially in first ed. A lot of swinging and missing at each other. Is with our outrageous strains, pretty much any hit on a goblin is a one-shot for melee. Any attack against the sleeping enemy is a one-shot for minimum, guaranteed. No chance to miss. same either way. Surprise party of kobolds, good. To get rid of this area, otherwise I'm going to be trying to avoid encounters as much as possible. Possibly even, reloading the game rather than fighting them if I get encounters, because they're so slow. Some of them are quick enough. Some also put me in danger of dying, so I'll need to reload anyway. Okay, that's 9. Maximum damage to 6 points. Okay. Excellent. Thank you. start to the surprise round. A lot of guys here, luckily. A lot of the biggest fights in the slums, the enemies are prevented from getting at you, so they tend to clump up nicely and become major victims for themselves. Sleep is such an amazing spell. One of the most powerful spells in any game relative to what it does in the level you have it. It quickly, even in this game, becomes obsolete for this one, but for these first battles, it can take down a guaranteed group of it and make them turn into one shots. Even for your otherwise worthless magic user. Thank you. Okay, and this is a good place to detect, just to make sure. We get a broadsword for you guys. And then chainmail and flail for you. Flail to chainmail to crane. One point of damage, how sad. Oops. I forgot to hit that friendly between counters thing. Considering how quickly I got it, that's not bad. Okay, now we find our first magic short bow and arrows. Battle with kobolds, kinda dangerous because they're a little spread out, not really dangerous, but oops. Didn't need to even save, whatever. Which finally will allow her to have a bit of armor. First at AD&D, your armor class, the lower the better. Throw a secret door, grab some more treasure. Let's see, we have another short bow and more arrows. And a lot of gems and stuff. Okay. He is almost out of arrows. So the next time we find a bunch of arrows, or when we go buy them. Plus add some minor buffs to your party, increasing your chance to hit and make saving throws. Let's see, in there. A lot of orcs in here, including some archers in the back, which can potentially be annoying. For the most part, with this narrow hallway, all these orcs just make this a time-consuming battle, not a dangerous one. Fortunately, it's also in a place where you can't quite get 9, and sometimes you can't quite get 8. Well, whatever. damage with bows, well, except for the fact that they're plus one. I guess that gives my archers a 50% chance to kill one of them at range. If they roll a 4 to 6 on their damage, plus 1 is 5. Surrender, but instead decide to flee. Goblin archers up here, and the fact that my mage is close enough to them, she often gets targeted. Come on, mage. Let's see, and that one moved, which means that 7 is the most I'm gonna hit now. I'd like my mage to go as fast as possible, too. Past that guy who's alive, he will take a swing at me from behind. But if I move up with my melee weapon, I can start beating him down. At least I'm not getting too many hits on him, especially my mage. With only 6 hit points, she can even one-shot my arrows if she gets really unlucky. Luckily, a 1 armor class is hard to hit for them, but they can do it. That was the last thing she got. Nice. Okay. Now some arrows for White to take. Set for arrows. Yoden, where Rogue Guild is the higher level section of this area. You don't want to come here until it gets cleared out. All the red encounters, so you don't get any. Speak, Volo. Sure, he totally told us to go with this potion, even though I've never seen it before. This one, the minor quest. I don't know if it's actually necessary to complete the slums, but it's a valuable little amount of experience anyway, as well as some random magic items, so it could potentially be worth it. And I'm not navigating the maze in this area very well right now. I actually didn't want to memorize well, and then I have to raise the rest of the day. Not going to turn into Olo yet, because that will overflow my experience. If you have enough experience to advance two levels, you lose experience, because you advance one level and go to the one lower than you need for the next level. So, actually, the first thing I need to do is go sell. I always forget that that's it. There's a quick way to go about it, but I always forget. If I can start remembering, that'll shave off a bit of time. Pool. Let's have silver buy some arrows. Guess he used a lot and didn't get quite as many as the white did. Haven't been doing it. That's good. Okay. How are we looking? 108. Okay, that's good. Oh, I need to divide up that money. 329. Okay. I don't need to memorize or identify anything yet. I know pretty much what everything is. I can train my cleric to level 2. My magic user level 2. Burn magic user is very important. And train 4 fighters to level 2. My cleric fighter can't train to level 2 fighter quite yet. That's okay, because I don't have the money. Okay, that's a split. Slums went very nicely. Hit points were great for green, really bad for white. White got minimum hit points. That is fantastic. Okay, cast sleep. Memorize 2 magic missiles. Memorize. Oh, that's right. Blast. When did I last save it? I can't actually rest for free anywhere in the slums yet, even though I've cleared out the encounters, because I haven't cleared out the slums. So this is going to be a small time waste. Especially since I don't have any spell memorized to deal with them. And they're going to have one archer shooting at me because of the side. Well, at least we're doing little sweeps to clear them out. There's a damage. Oh. Okay, she just went down, it looks like. Not a huge deal. Since this isn't really a lot of experience, it's like 20. But, I think the biggest thing is that it, raises their hit morale stat, so they're less likely to surrender. AI sometimes. No, down. Down, you fool. Oh well, it surrenders. So she lost about 60 experience. Well, let's see. On the other hand, since they are archers. Take some arrows. And it gives me a little bit I can improve on next time. Okay. Cast. Cure Light Wounds. One hit point. Well, as long as she's awake for to get experience. Yeah. Got where it was. I get a plus two longsword. I did. Awesome. That's one of the most valuable things you can get. Longsword is overall the best weapon in the game because it's one-handed. It does 1d8 to medium and small creatures, and it does 1d12 to large creatures. And the only item that does more to large creatures is... sword, which is two-handed, so you can't use a shield with it and get that bonus armor class. My troll fight went super duper well last time. Last thing she's able to do, and then she resists 4 damage is good. It's not much, but it's every little bit counts when it's guaranteed damage. You're useless now. Green could very well die here, or get knocked out at least. Yep, there we go. Hopefully he's not dead. Unconscious. Okay, he just went down to 0. That's bad, he's gonna lose experience, but could be worse. Ouch. Now she's getting hit. It's really bad if she falls. Ogre on her is better though than the troll. Okay, that's 2 trolls down. Come on. Oh, he surrendered. Excellent. Oh, blast. Okay, fine. Okay. Oh no! Oh, phew. Okay, broadsword, magic user, scroll, two-hand sword. Yeah, you can take stuff when you're unconscious, we just stuffed in your bags. Okay. I won again. Experience hurts early on, but it's not a big deal. By the end of the game, everything will be evened out. Let's buy a couple more daggers for you to money change. Whenever you buy anything, it changes all your small money into big money, so. And appraise, jewelry, sell. Okay, that should be more than enough money for everybody. Well, actually, he still needs a little bit more, so we'll do this. Trade that to silver. This will actually be a little bit quicker. View items. Sell the leather armor for 1,000 gold. Okay, now he has enough to drain both his levels. Items. Let me make sure I recognize that's more money. What are you? Just a plus one? Okay. Go ahead and trade that to Silver, who doesn't have a magic weapon yet. What are you? Plus one. Yeah, it's not great. I'll keep it around because I think I want it more than the money right now. That was it, right? Okay, we need to identify your scroll for magic missiles so we can scry it. Okay. So I'll keep as next after we or the training almost for a second. That's unusual. Sticking cloud is absolutely the one I want to learn. Again, our hit points are not great. Night. fight. Yay, one taken down. I really hope they didn't hit my mage. She's already vulnerable to arrows. She starts in a bad position in this fight, and there's nothing I can do about it. I need her to move early, but it doesn't always happen. This is not one of the longest, but it's one of the most annoying fights in the game. Or, I mean, it's not one of the hardest, but it's one of the longest and most annoying. Yes, they did hit her, which means she can't do anything either. If you get hit before you take your action, you can't cast spells. By the same token, if you get hit while you're casting a long cast spell, you can't use spells either. I don't think delay will actually do anything at all, but because it's still this turn. Spells again, see if there's anything useful. Mostly the only thing that really would be useful would be haste. Otherwise, it's just spells that I can eventually cast and sometimes. Doing a decent job taking them out. They're not taking too much damage. Having +2 longsword for this is a big help since it's, as I say, best weapon in the game, and +2 means 4. I need that guy to be gone so I can move without getting hit. Not guaranteed to get hit, but it's not worth it to take the risk to maneuver to try to cast spells. Now let my mage go. everybody downwind has been taken out, so now I can start using arrows, which may speed up things. I can use spells, which will really speed up things. Sleep spells would have done nothing in the battle against the ogres and trolls, really. But that's why magic missiles to do as much damage to the trolls as I could. I thought about that too before that troll got up. I was going to move into its space and stand on him. That would have prevented him from getting up, but I thought about it after I stopped my wizard. I'm like, I should go do that and might get up. Then he did, right when I thought that all was well. Okay, right here. Excellent. Chokes. Stinky Cloud's an interesting spell. It's kind of better and kind of worse than Sleep. Shorter area can affect my party as well. So can Sleep if my position wrong, but my characters can wander into it. They won't when they're automatically controlled, interestingly. They will in the Xscape Prison of the Azure Bonds. Computers will also not wander into it unless they started in it. Buffs them while they're in it as well. They generally almost always start to cough at least. Affects a random amount of creatures, usually everybody in the square, but not always. There we Slums and so-called keep splits last time were really, really good. These ones were very not good. There we go. fighter, but not a level 4 cleric. I can train all 4 fighters. Buy some darts. Join. Still need to do that. Let's see. You can drop your longsword. You can drop your longsword as well. Trade your broadsword to white. You cannot level to level 4. That's where it starts to get unfortunate, but not a huge deal. Okay, share. I don't need to. I'm one short. Okay, so I do need to do something. Let's go to view items. Full share. Okay. It's unfortunate because green's the one who's rolling the best hit points. Four of the five fighters can train. Seriously? Having the magical armor makes me move faster. Plus one chainmail's the same as banded mail, except you have a movement of 12, which is good for those guys with powerful melee weapons, because I want to use those. Bracers are all the money I have. Thank you. just wiped out your entire squad. Surrender already. Okay, there we go. No, we don't want to climb up the rocks. Surrender or die. I think I'll fight. I think I'll choose option B. No view, and of course, no damage. Underneath the well, I can rest without interruption. In the well, though, let's see, next fight is the pyramid. I need a missile for that. Not that I really need it. Pretty much only get attacked now if I get surprised, but it happens more often than you'd like to think it would. Just wrong place. Only the money being used to buy with. If you pull money, everybody gets to use it. 180, which isn't enough, so... appraise, gem cell. Jeez. Okay, view items, fine. We're gonna do it this way. So, IDS. I still need to do... full share. Okay, now we have money. You can put not that, so that's fine. Green can now train. Guys are gonna be a while, okay. What? Oh, he needs 6,000. Sorry. Okay. It doesn't even matter. I need to just learn strength. Level mage is important though. No, I don't want to enter a small wooded grove. I don't know what that is, but it's not necessary. I'm kind of curious, but there are a couple of random places, I guess. Okay. Just in case I get lost in the maze, I don't want to get lost in the maze. I know exactly what to do, but if I do miss something, throw, move on. A lot more damage than I usually take. Memorize sleep. So we're resting for days, so I guess it makes sense that even though we didn't destroy the equipment, they... Okay, change it to copper. Treasure room 1. Random treasure is magic user scrolls and a shield. Plus 1 is off. Change it to silver. Treasure room 2. Two more magic user sticks and a Joe stick. Which might be plus 2 if I'm lucky. Change it to gold. Boom, elsewhere. Share, take. And another broadsword, which is probably just plus 1. Magically changes back because we killed the guy who was causing the pollution, even though we didn't actually do anything about it. I have a feeling that, oh, to civilized area. Thank you. so many scrolls. And just plus one item, so not as good as the long sword. I didn't get anything else interesting, right? Yeah, this is all stuff I know about. That's my potion of speed. I need to make sure not to confuse it with anything else. Okay, now they can level up to 5. I think even he can level up to 5. You can level up to a level 4 fighter. You cannot level up yet, but you're close and close. So doing the last few quests will get her up.
Thank you.
yeah. Box. We're going to take items I need to share first. It's faster. It's Vogar power. Now he has 18100 strength, just like the rest of the fighters. And that gets the guy very mad at us for opening his family box, but he's a bad guy, so we don't care anyway. And we're not going to be dealing with him anymore. In fact, there's actually time is calculated. Oh yeah, the guy gets mad at us for opening stuff. Fireball at Surrender. Okay, nobody else can level right now, so... Okay, I doubt I'll get off four sleep spells in a single battle, so... Time to go to the temple. Used to be a temple to Tyr, the good god, but now Tyranthraxus' forces have desecrated it. Okay, south side of the city. Okay, now if we're very lucky, Durton won't ever get off his prayer spell. He's totally computer controlled, so I can't do anything about it. Casting one of my sleep spells is actually useful here. This is a larger group than I usually remember being here. Maybe I just don't pay much attention. Time in the game I'll get to have it is with him, so if he uses it early, I don't get to use it for the big fight, which just makes it a tiny bit slower. No, I don't think I am. He's about that in a better position. For some reason, in this area, you don't run randomly when you flee enemies, so unless you... get surprised, the encounters are not bad. That's really nice when it happens, because I avoid a fight. Sometimes I get a random holy symbol from the orcs that I, killed there. Trap door. Let's see. Wand is fake. I'm not sure if the pilot takes the wand. Cleric, so he can do that whole person spell, and if he does that to my guys, of course, that's very bad, so that's... yeah, that's the best. I will get almost all those guys, all but five, this whole map. Yay, fireballs! This is why I want people to fight. Thank you. dies in this path, because it'll be removed without dialogue. But the dialogue takes like just a couple frames to go through, so it's not like it's a big deal. You can do it. Though they look like orc leaders, they're just ordinary orcs but have bows. Kind of weird that they do that. Jeez, something damaged me. Should be surrendering my door. To fanatics for nothing. So there are three treasure piles in that room, and you get that encounter, this encounter, when you open all three or when you try to leave, whether you open any or not. So I found it's fastest to actually go open the one, then come out for the battle, and then we'll actually... One guy, but he's still not surrendering. Oh well. Okay, there's a magic plus one mace. So Durton left, so he's going to be fixing up the temple, he says. We're like, okay, go for it. One sleep spell left, we don't need it anymore. The last few monsters are pretty much immune to sleep, so... It's now totally safe to rest in the temple. I don't know if it's safe to rest anywhere else, but... We're, anyway, we should be done with all random encounters, so I'm spending time. Potion of speed to blue. If I get a second potion of giant strength, that's really awesome. Share. I actually can't level again though, so it doesn't matter who has what money. Okay, tiding towards the final encounter. Dust of Disappearance was the one thing I needed there. That makes the final battle doable. And pretty easy for the most part, but without it, it's ridiculously hard. Surprise the guards in these tower who are not expecting anything. There are a couple of humans, and we advance by and force them to us. Can't really start with that. Pets are surprisingly vulnerable to stinking blood. have another plus one, right? Oh, there it is. I forgot to identify that, but that's one magic missiles. So attacking them sounded the alarm, but because I'm going to be resting, I forgot to memorize with him. Hit points are decent this time for the most part. Red is a little low. Silver isn't too bad. Blue and green have both have really good. White is okay. I might be able to get by without doing these guys as well, actually. I said that his hit points were low. We can kill him first. I forgot to bless too. Not that it matters that much. Not gonna get a 145, but I might get a 150 depending on how the rest of the fights go. This is one of the few fights where I can defend something. Oh, yes. Getting Fireball off immediately is real good, because now I can not worry about hitting my own party members. Good Fireball? 17. Kill if they don't save, so it's a matter of saves. One of the best things I can get is a scroll of haste. Okay, that's going to be it, but I didn't get a scroll of haste, so I have a wand of that, a wand of paralyzation. Is actually useful, although not that useful. Okay, that's Stinking Cloud. That's the one I want first. Okay. That's game. Always for this. Okay, take, exit share, take. I don't actually need the rings. They don't help my armor class at all. Saving throws, possibly, but not in any. They help her armor class. Okay, standard mail short bow. So after being invisible, looting all the guards, and charging in here, now we're charging on the guards invisible and killing them all, now we're looting them all as well. Tries to breathe, he can't. Because he doesn't see a thing to breathe on. It's a big wet spell, so you think he could just toss it out randomly. Oh, we lost a guy. Oh well. Killed Tyranthraxus, so it doesn't matter. Mortally wounded, the dragon roars. The spirit of Tyranthraxus flares up from the dragon's body. You have but slain the body I possessed. I cannot be defeated. With the power of the pool of radiance which I moved here to my lair, I will still rule by possessing one of you. Maybe the dead guy. That'd be a good one, right? Of course, we leave this Bull of Rain's alone. No, Lord Bane, I can still rule who I have not failed. Ah, finally ran towards the civilized area of Phlan. That's it. Okay, we have one. We could continue adventuring if we wanted. Or is he dead? He is dead, not that it matters. Because we won, who cares if Red died? We can resurrect him too, which I'll do just for the heck of it. I love that. You have to make sure you have enough money by doing things like heal. Do I still not have the money? That's funny. Wow. I have a charmer class. Did these happen to be bigger? That's for levels too. Oh, because they're using their one-handed weapons instead of quick combat because they're just as good. Okay, well, whatever. Didn't help Reddit. Jewelry, 124. Okay, there's the money I need to resurrect him. Unfortunately, using Ray's dead, even though this is possible, I'd never do a real game because it's super expensive and permanently lowers your constitution, which means lower hit points. So, yes. So we've all the money we need. You don't need a lot of money in this game because you can't buy magic items or anything with it. So training is about all it's really used for. Anyway, that's gonna be it there. Pretty nice run, not quite a 145, but 146 is really good. Despite having a really awful final bit of slums, that sleep was a mess up, the troll fight was bad, so-called keep was really rough, but I managed to make up enough time elsewhere to really cut that down, so that was a good run. Thanks for watching. I don't think I have anybody really to host right now, so I'm just gonna tomorrow, I'll probably try and get a burn here and use some particles in the sword instead. But pretty satisfied about the radiance of those. I didn't need to use it much here, which was one of the reasons my time was good, but shoutouts to like.com who's been talking to me about this. I was running into problems before because the game auto loads on full screen. I used the DOSBox shortcut to run it that good old games provides you. Said that I should have a way of getting it to not load in full screen, so I actually looked closer after he mentioned that. It's like, yeah, maybe I can. Looked through the executable, found the config that it loads up. It's programmed to load up and was able to change full screen to false, so that'll save me a bit of time because it usually takes about 10 seconds to load up in full screen. Therefore, me go out of full screen so I can load up my map and live split and Steam chat and everything else I need to have on hand to look at as well. So that, thanks to lag.com for telling me about that. Anywho, I'm out. Have a good weekend, the rest of you, and looking forward to SGDQ starting tomorrow. I hope you guys are too.